The world of football remains largely in shock following the arrest of many top officials and the resignation of the FIFA president. Here's the latest.
Former vice president of FIFA Jack Warner of Trinidad and Tobago went on national television in his country to say he feared for his life because of all the information he has regarding FIFA corruption. He said the football organization went as far as illegally funding elections in the Caribbean nation. He also said he has piles of evidence that he will soon make public.
I also will give them my knowledge of financial transactions at FIFA, including but not limited to Sepp Blatter.
Warner's statement came just hours after it was revealed that U.S. former FIFA executive Charles Blazer had admitted to receiving bribes in writings for the 1998 World Cup in France and the 2010 in South Africa. Blazer served as a whistleblower after a guilty plea agreement in November 2013. He wore a microphone to help U.S. authorities in their investigations into alleged FIFA corruption. And a day after information surfaced that the FBI and U.S. prosecutors were investigating Joseph Blatter, U.S. Attorney General Loretta Lynch declined to comment whether he was under investigation. She also refused to comment regarding Blatter's decision to resign. Lynch confirmed matters involving the World Cup awarding to be Russia in 2018 and Qatar in 2022 were being investigated by Swiss authorities.
We are not able to comment further on the nature of other individuals who may or may not be under investigation.
After London Mayor Boris Johnson said his city was prepared to celebrate a World Cup if it were to be canceled elsewhere, Russian top officials dismissed concern that the country might lose the right to host the 2018 World Cup finals or face a boycott by other nations. Reuters said the awarding of the World Cup to Russia and Qatar was being investigated by the FBI.
And those allegations by Jack Warner are sending shockwaves through the political system there in Trinidad and Tobago. In a paid TV message, Warner said that FIFA influenced the outcome of the country's 2010 national elections. Now, Warner says that he has evidence to link funding by FIFA and himself to the current prime minister's political party, the United National Congress. He also says the evidence is in the form of checks and corroborated statements. Local press report that a company owned by Warner paid a local private advertising firm over $270,000 for the United National Congress's campaign 1 month before the 2010 elections. Trinidad and Tobago's Prime Minister Kamla Persad Bisesar has denied receiving any money from Warner to fund either her party or herself during the 2010 election campaign.